Welcome to the second video in our HitFilm Basics Masterclass. In this tutorial, we're going to show you how to begin editing your videos. So things like trimming and adding video to the timeline, going over the editing tools, and if you missed the last tutorial on how to actually download HitFilm Express, you can find that in the card on screen. Let's go ahead and dive right into HitFilm Express. I've got a new project here and I've imported some media which we covered at the end of the last episode. These are just clips from our Day in the Life episode where we vlogged our workday here at FXhome.
Morning.
How's it going?
Hey, we're going to do 60 miles an hour.
It's like in my mouth.
Oh, great, yeah.
Up in the top left, you have the trimmer here. Now, the trimmer does not represent what you're going to actually output. It's just a way to see what the clip looks like before you actually put it on the timeline. If you want to see a different clip inside of the trimmer, just click on it in the media panel. Let's take this example here. The trimmer works based on what you call in and out points. This is basically telling HitFilm at which point you want to start the video and at which point you want to end it. So if I scrub through here until I'm a little bit closer, let's say I want to start the clip at this point. What I'll do is come over and select the Set In Point button. The orange section of the timeline represents which part of the clip is going to be played. Now I'll skip through and decide where I want to end it, and then I'll click the Set Out Point button. You can also use the I and O keys, which are keyboard shortcuts. Now that I've got my in and out points selected, I can click and drag the video down into the timeline. You might get this message that says the editor settings differ from the clip you're adding. This is up to you to determine what you want your settings to be. Over here in the media panel, I can see that my clip is 1920 by 1080 at 29.97 frames per second. This is a good standard, so I'll go ahead and select yes to change my project to fit those settings. This viewer section represents how the final video will look. Down here in the timeline, you have a little zoom bar if you need to see things in greater detail. And depending on how your settings default, you may or may not see previews in the timeline here. You can change that by coming up to this hamburger icon for track options, select that, and then change the video size to something different. If you still don't see any thumbnails, go back to the menu and select preview mode and change it from none to one of the other options. I'm going to go ahead and skip forward a bit to fill in the timeline some more. Now we've got a little edit going with multiple clips playing one after another. Let's take a look at the tools you can use to edit your footage. They can be found over here on the left. The one you'll probably use most is the selection tool, which is the default. This is useful for moving clips around, and you can also, if you hover your mouse on the edge of one, change the in and out points by dragging. You can click and drag an empty space to highlight multiple clips and then move them all at the same time. The next icon is for the drag tool. This is useful if you want to pan around the timeline without actually moving anything. Next up is the slice tool. This is how you make a cut in your footage. So I'll just position it over this clip here, and you can see that it snaps to where the timeline indicator is. Click once to make a cut, and then if I change back to the selection tool, I can then move this clip somewhere else. A useful option, if you right-click in a gap and then you select Ripple Delete Gap, it'll move everything to the right of the timeline to fill that space. Next, we have the Slip tool. This tool lets you move the in and out points of a clip, but not actually move the clip itself. Here we have the first one here, and you can see that it ends at about 2 seconds and 14 frames. I can tell that by this number here. If I want to adjust the in and out points, I can select the Slip tool, and then click and drag inside the clip itself. And you can see that the viewer is updating to show me what those new in and out points will be. So if I continue to drag, I'll eventually get a new clip there. And now this is the clip that's playing instead, but nothing else on the timeline has been affected. The slide tool allows you to move a clip but maintain its in and out points, but then compensates the surrounding clips to fill the gaps. So if I use the slide tool on this clip here, I can move it over to the left, and the clip on the left and right will trim automatically to fill the gap. Then we have the Ripple Edit tool, which is useful for adjusting the in and out points of a single clip. If I adjust this clip here, you can see that it pushes all of the other ones to the right, and if I move it to the left, it brings all of those clips in line. Then we have the Roll Edit tool, which lets you adjust the in and out points of two clips, and automatically fills in the gaps as well. Finally, we have the Rate Stretch tool, which lets you speed up or slow down clips. This one does not automatically fill the gaps. This is a quick way to speed up or slow down your footage. If you're interested in making your workflow faster, you might want to check out the keyboard shortcuts. All of these tools have their own shortcuts, but you can customize them in the File, Options menu. Here we have a list of some categories and all of the corresponding shortcuts. You can clear or reset them, or customize them yourself. You can perform a J or L cut by holding down the Alt key and clicking and dragging one area of the timeline. In this example here, I'm trimming the video of one clip but not the audio. I can then fill in the gap for the other video using the same technique, and this means that the audio from one clip will play before the actual video shows. This is useful for hiding cuts inside of your footage and making the transitions more smooth.
How's it going?
All right, how are you?
Good stuff, yeah?
What are we working on?
Some stuff.
Stuff.
Secret
things.
Stuff.
HitFilm Express has a number of built-in transitions that are very easy to apply. If you come over here to the effects panel and then scroll down to transitions video, you can see some folders and transitions here. We have a couple transitions for motion, some for dissolves. As an example, I'll just drag on the additive dissolve and place it in this area between the two clips. There's the transition, and if you want to adjust the duration of it, you can click and drag similar to adjusting clips and make it either smaller or larger. If you want to adjust one side of the transition, hold down the Shift key and click and drag. Now let's take a quick look at the controls panel, which is probably one of the most important panels in HitFilm. Let's say we have this clip here, and I want to zoom in on Ollie's face halfway through. To start, I'll come over here and select the slice tool, and then make a cut where I want it to transition. So let's say right here. Then I'll come back to the selection tool and select this second piece of the clip. Now come over to the controls panel. The controls panel depends on which clip you have active at that moment. So if I click on this one here, that video will become active instead. It's important to make sure that you've clicked on the right clip before you start adjusting the controls. Down here in the transform properties, you can see a couple of things that you can adjust, like the position, so I can move it left, right, up, or down. I could also use the control handle here. Remember that the viewer is what the final output would be, so if I were to export this right now, it would have a black line on the left and bottom, which probably isn't ideal. Let's go ahead and reset that by right-clicking and selecting Reset. We can also adjust the scale so we can make it bigger or smaller. And in this case, I actually do want to make it bigger, so I'll go ahead and leave that, and then adjust the position to focus on his face. If I wanted, I could also rotate it, or adjust the opacity, which is how transparent it is. There's also a line on the timeline itself to adjust the opacity for a quicker result. Now, if I play it back, you'll see the regular clip, and then it cuts to a close-up of Ollie's face. The controls panel is basically where you want to go if you want to adjust any parameter of the video or effect that you've applied. A new project in HitFilm will start with one video track and one audio track. You can see that here on the left. You can add as many as you like by right-clicking and selecting Insert Track. This will put a new video track up above, and then I could, for example, put this one here. If I wanted to maybe keep it more organized or split it up so that it's easier to see. You have two icons on each track. The first is an eye to hide it from view, and the second is a lock icon. Once the lock is applied, you can't make any changes, so you can't move anything, you can't trim it, it's locked. So now we've taken a look at the ins and outs of editing video inside of HitFilm. In the next tutorial, we'll show you how to add text inside the software. Click the card on screen to be taken there right now. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you all in the next video.